Good morning, grade 10s. Just like yesterday, I thought I would record some instructions for you so that you have an idea of what you're doing. You can follow along here so that you have a little explanation of today's task and you're able to dive in. So, just like every other day, same routine, you're arriving at your course home. Have a look at our agenda. You can join the Google Meet using the calendar link right here. Your Minds On is in content, and then you're going to dive into the next two modules under our biography content module, biography assignment, and exploring creative biographies. And that's what I'm going to take you through today. So, your Minds On, of course, is in content under the Minds On module. I did make a little note here, you know, that if we're sick, we can't go in, and I have a cold, so does my son. So we're waiting till we're symptom-free, which kind of sucks. So under Minds On, we've got our Minds On activity for Wednesday, September 23rd. It's a Google form. You're going to click on it and answer the questions. Hopefully, you find it interesting. And then under Sharing Perspectives, Biographical Writing, you're scrolling all the way down to Biography Presentations. So I want you to keep in mind the features of biography that we talked about earlier in the week on Monday. Now that you've had a chance to think about the power of biographies to teach us about different perspectives, how to handle adversity, and about perseverance, you're going to be putting together your very own biography presentation. So your job today is to start to think about what your presentation is going to look like and who it is that you're going to research to present. You're going to pick a subject and research them. Then you will pick a specific question from the biography presentation assignment sheet. I'm going to show you that in a moment. You can choose from five different oral presentation formats to complete this presentation. Each presentation format has its own features. So, as a class, we will be discussing what you will have to do to complete the assignment and submit it. All presentations are going to be recorded and submitted. Unfortunately, we just don't have time in the quadmaster to present to the whole class. Be creative and have fun. Remember to choose a subject that you're interested in and whose life exemplifies facing adversity with resilience and perseverance. So, if you have a look at the biography presentation assignment sheet, it's going to outline for you what you are supposed to do. First off, you're going to choose one of these questions to answer in your presentation. And each question allows you to focus on a slightly different aspect of the individual's life, whoever it is that you choose to be your subject, so that you're honing in on a particular kind of adversity, resilience, achievement. So the first question is, if you were making a list of 50 people's lives that should be studied in school, would your subject make the list? Why or why not? And then the rest follow. There are, I think, seven questions to choose from. So you're going to select one of these to answer for your subject. Then if you scroll down to the bottom, we've got five different formats that you can choose from in order to actually present. You can create a podcast. You can create a formal oral presentation with Google Slides. So that would be the kind of presentation you would do in class. You can create a monologue or speech spoken from the perspective of the subject. So in this option, number three, you would take on the voice of your person, the person that you've selected to do the biography on, and you say a speech based on what they think or what they would say based on your research. Number four is a well-developed spoken word poem, and we're going to explore what that looks like in a moment. And finally, you could create a YouTube video. So rather than just a Google Slides presentation, if you are into making films or if you'd like to put something together that's a little more creative, similar to the kinds of videos we watched in the biography, using the biography website, if you watched any of their videos, you could create something like that. Your presentation should be between 5 and 8 minutes long. And then the following pages give you a little bit of planning, some planning tools so that you can start to get your research together. The biography rubric checklist will help you know what I'm going to be looking for. It provides you with some success criteria. So really, for today, you want to start identifying who it is that you're going to be doing your project on. So you really want to have an idea of your subject and you know, a little bit of your research done by the end of today's class period. Now, if you click on the next module, I do have an activity for you that gets you thinking about the different formats that your presentation can take. And I've posted several different YouTube videos here. They're all biographical texts, but they're all presented differently. So this one here by Shane Coyson is a spoken word poem. This one here is a YouTube video for children. This one is one geared more towards adults, and it's made by the Biography Channel. And then this one is a kind of TED Talk. It was created by the TED organization. So they're all slightly different, but they give you an idea of how creatively you can approach this project. Please watch all of them, because by exploring the different biographical texts, you are going to have a sense of like what the expectation is of you. And it gives you an idea of how you can tackle this. And then in here, I have you discussing what you've watched in those videos. So it gives you a chance to kind of think about the format, which was most effective, which showed, you know, some of the features of biography best. And I've posted a sample response right here. I'm asking that you post your response in answer, prove, explain format. And this is the response that I posted, so that you start to practice that really good paragraph response format when answering questions. So I've started with an answer. I've moved on to a very specific proof, and then I've got my explanation. I want you to practice that format when you are responding to the discussion. So really today, there are a couple of things that you're working on. I'm going to take you back to your agenda to look at what's listed. You're having a look at the biography assignment so that you get a sense of what it's all about. You want to choose who your subject is. Choose who your subject is. You're going to have time to explore different creative biographies and respond to the discussion. And at the end of the period, I've got an exit pass here for you to complete so that you can tell me who your subject is going to be for your presentation. So by the end of this class period, you should have watched a few of those videos. You should have chosen who your person's going to be and started your research. And you should respond to that discussion post that is LinkedIn content. I hope you have a great day, guys. I can answer questions for you if you like through email. And of course, Ms. Hamid is here with you so that you have a sense of what's going on. She can tackle questions as well. Thanks so much for bearing with me, and I hope to see you tomorrow. Have a great day.